All right, you ready?
I'm ready.
I've traveled every road in this here land. I've been everywhere, man. I've been everywhere, man. Across the deserts bare, man. I breathe the mountain air, man. I've traveled, I've had my share, man. I've been everywhere.
Amelia Presley, welcome to Bandwagon TV, all the way from Cross Plains, Texas. How are you? Good. Well, we're so glad that you were able to meet us and really to show us around Cross Plains just south of Abilene.
That's right.
There you go. I did my research.
That's pretty impressive.
Well, you're really just
nobody
up.
Nobody knows where we are.
Well, yeah, you're just up the road. We're calling you from, we've traveled all the way from Lampasas, Texas, so not too far.
Right.
So we are so happy to have you. Just if you could explain a little bit about yourself, people who are familiar, people maybe who aren't, and a little bit about your musical story.
Okay. Well, my name is Amelia Presley. I'm from South Mississippi. I moved to Texas about 3 years ago. And I moved here because I'm in a duo called the Highway Sisters. And so that was kind of taken off in Texas. So I decided to make the permanent move here. And I'm so glad that I did. And then I just continued on with my solo career as well. And just so happens that Texas is where it's at, which I'm sure all of y'all already know that. but yeah.
Well, we're so happy, one, we can't wait to really showcase your music, but you're part of our Quarantine Confessions, our Memorial Day special, and you happen to be a veteran of the Coast Guard. We wanted to share your story and a little bit about how you got into the Coast Guard and then how your music influenced you from there on out and really how you became who you are today.
You know, it's not as patriotic of a story as you might be hoping for, but I dropped out of high school when I had like a couple of semesters left of my senior year, and I got my GED, and I wasn't doing the best things with my life. My entire life, I knew that I wanted to be a singer. I knew that was what I wanted to do, and that just never left me. Like, I mean, it's you know, through the School of Hard Knocks, I realized that you cannot really get into this business unless you are able to invest in yourself. And being a high school dropout, working at a bar, you know, I didn't have the extra funds to invest in myself. So I thought the military would be the way to go. And I looked into really all the branches. Mm-hmm. And the only one that was like, they did not care whether I joined or fell off a cliff was the Coast Guard. And I was like, okay, there must be something to this. They ended up having to do a waiver because it is actually pretty difficult to get into the Coast Guard. But I had a perfect GED score, which sounds like, I don't know, sounds like a participation medal. But but I had a high score on my GED. I made a perfect score on that. And then I took my ASVAB, and I had a really high score on my ASVAB. And so I think they were only interested in talking to me because of that.
So were they playing a little hard to get?
They were. It is a really small branch, and they are pretty selective with who they let in. I was so determined that they were going to take me that I did not stop calling them until they brought me in for an interview. And once they brought me in for the interview, they realized that that they better take me or I was not going to go away.
So you just bugged them.
Just bugged the heck out of them. Yeah. And they finally, like, all right.
Oh, so they were forced to take in you. Well, I'm glad that they did. You got a great story now. I guess paving the way for a successful life, and military does do that. For you, it sounds to me like not only did it help you in terms of your lifestyle, but music, now you're able to do what you love.
Yeah, I actually recorded my first album while I was in. I was just, you know, saving up my military pay, and I also ended up having to sell a horse and a horse trailer to to finish it off. But I got it done. I actually had to, so I started recording the album, my first album, No Pony Ride, and I named it No Pony Ride because I had to sell my horse.
Mm-hmm.
But the way that I finished it was I was scheduled in the studio during my machinery technician training, and you're not allowed to leave the base unless you're just, like, you can go, it was in it was in Yorktown, Virginia, and we were pretty close to Virginia Beach, so like we were allowed on the weekends to go to Virginia Beach or something like that. We didn't have to stay in the barracks. We weren't allowed to like go very far, and so I put in, it's called a chit, to leave, and gave them my explanation, and they're like, no. And so one weekend, I just didn't say anything to anyone. I didn't say anything to my roommate. And I left the barracks and I left the base and I left for the entire weekend and I drove all night to Nashville. I slept in my truck. Got to Nashville just a little bit late. I had to call the producer. I was like, I'm sorry, I woke up late because I was sleeping in my truck. I drove straight through and got to Nashville and recorded all day long. And then I left right then and I had to drive all the way back to Yorktown, Virginia and sleep in my truck again. And I got back Sunday night, I believe, right in classes were starting on Monday morning. And I just walked in and everybody's like, where did you go? I was like, I just, Virginia Beach. They're like, by yourself? I'm like, mm-hmm.
Yeah. Oh, that's a great story.
I actually don't think I've ever told that story.
Well, you see, it's what we get out of artists right here. This is what Bandwagon TV is all about.
You heard it first here. Yes. I'm a delinquent.
Well, we really appreciate you telling us that story. Amelia, are you ready for the lightning round?
I'm sure. Yeah. Okay. Sorry, but let's do it.
Let's go. All right. So you are in the white lightning. I have to pull this over. Usually I will promote a business, but today, because it's Memorial Day weekend, I really wanted to promote veteran-owned businesses. And you actually work with one and own one yourself. Do you mind plugging it?
Yeah, heck yeah. So I was a brand ambassador for Kick and Brass for about a year. And then just recently in January, they made me a co-owner of the company. What we are is a patriotic apparel company. And we also have a gun range app. So the gun range app is a little different from other apps that are out there because you can actually challenge your friends. So you can go to the range and use a target and score your target. And then you can challenge your friend to beat it. And so they'll send in their score. And you have to show a picture of your target too. You can't lie to beat your buddy. But it's pretty cool. So Kick and Brass. Actually, if you want to go check out the shirts or hats or anything, you can use my discount code. It's just Amelia15, and it'll get you 15% off.
Oh, wow. Well, we'll definitely have it plugged here in this video, and we'll use a tag, but thank you so much. And really, this goes across the board to all veteran-owned businesses. You know, I'm sure everyone has one in their town, their city, so definitely check them out. Look for them. They could always be appreciated with your help. So thank you so much for sharing, Amelia. But now it is the lightning round, so we make sure that you are ready, and we will go from there. All right, Amelia Presley, first question. Favorite drink, beer or whiskey?
Oh, whiskey.
You got a favorite whiskey?
I like Jack Daniels. It doesn't like me back.
No, it doesn't like a lot of people back.
It lets me know the next morning.
How do you like it? Do you like it with Coke, on the rocks?
I like it neat. On the rocks. I like it with Coke, and I like it just straight.
Straight?
I'm not picky when it comes to Jack.
You are a cowboy. All right, Amelia, you told me that your dad was a huge influence growing up in terms of music, and you were really into classic rock. So I have to ask you, there is no wrong answer in the lightning round. It's just really us prying. So to choose one band, you have to choose Boston or Lynyrd Skynyrd.
Ooh, I have to pick between those two.
Yeah, you do, yeah.
Oh, no. I would have to say Lynyrd Skynyrd.
Any reason? Is it just because you're from the South?
Mostly because I would take my Lynyrd Skynyrd CD and go and park down by the river and sit on the top of my beat up car and just blare Lynyrd Skynyrd for hours and sulk. So
what one song, if you could pick a Lynyrd Skynyrd song, you have a favorite? I know there's so many.
This is probably really cliche, but Simple Man.
Yeah.
I love that song. Give Me Three Steps is another good one.
Yeah.
Cool.
Oh,
Curtis Lowe. I don't know.
That's all right. There's so many. There's no wrong answer, and we just appreciate you sharing. All right. I know you're in the Coast Guard, but I have to still ask you your favorite MRE, which is a meal ready to eat. Do you have a favorite MRE?
You know, I ate MREs back when I was a kid. We went through Hurricane Katrina in South Mississippi, so we had to eat MREs for a while, but I did not eat MREs while I was in the Coast Guard. We actually had cooks.
How was that?
arguably probably worse than an MRE.
I've heard.
Some of them were decent. Yeah. I don't want to, you know, throw my shipmates under the bus, but sometimes it was like, what is this?
Yeah. At least with an MRE, at least they tell you what it is.
That's true, but I'm also really not picky, and I was always really close to the cooks because everybody would hate on them because, you know, they're working with what they got.
Yeah, obviously, it's a tough job.
They can't do much with it.
Yeah.
And but I was always buddy-buddy with them because I was like, you know what? All you have to do is feed me. That's all anybody has to do to be my friend. I just appreciate you feeding me every day. I was excited about lunch, whether it was a tire on a on a plate or not.
Well, that's a good strategy.
Take what you can get.
So, Amelia, if you were stranded on an island, what band would you want to keep you company?
Oh, man. I would have to pick... I'd have to go with my friends at the Lawless just because I love those guys and they're friends of mine. I don't want to pick like a band that I don't know because maybe they're assholes. So
it's true. You never know. It's like kind of meeting your favorite celebrity. You don't know if you really want to meet them because your aspect of them would totally change.
Yeah, true.
So now you got your friends that you have. It's it's guaranteed no bad times.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay. All right. If we were to look into a playlist on your phone, is there a song or band that would surprise us?
Probably honestly not. I listen to Red Dirt and Texas Country and classic rock and I don't know, everything that kind of encompasses or is encompassed by Americana, just like a broad spectrum of rock, country, blues, all that stuff. There's not really any pop or pop country.
Okay. How about there isn't, like Nickelback has been a very popular answer here.
I don't currently have them, but I did love them when I was in high school. Yeah. So anybody can hate on me. I don't care. Nickelback was the shit, and I don't care who says differently.
There we go. Another Nickelback plug. Love it. Amelia, you're doing great. We got one last question. We want to know, you got any special plans for Memorial Day?
I don't currently. Probably, you're probably looking at it. I'm probably going to be hearing the tune shit.
Yeah. Playing some tunes?
Playing some tunes, writing some music, maybe making some videos. Who knows?
Well, thank you so much, Amelia. Really, we really appreciate your service to our country. You have no idea. And but this last part's on you. We all want to know, how do we follow you? How do we listen to you? How do we keep updated with Amelia Presley?
You can find me on social media, facebook.com/AmeliaPresleyMusic. Instagram, I'm just at Amelia Presley Music. Twitter, if you are high tech and do that, it's just Amelia_Presley. If you want to find all that information, though, you can go to my website, AmeliaPresleyMusic.com. Everything's there. I do have a new single coming out. It's called Harm Nobody Else. It's very, very important to me. If you want to read more about it, it is on my website, but it will be available for pre-order and pre-save on Spotify this Friday.
That's great. Yeah, no, it's a really good song. And I'm so glad that, you know, we caught you at a good time when you're about to debut that single, and it's just exciting. I can't imagine, so.
I forgot that we were talking in past tense.
It's okay. I can fix it all in editing. Or I might leave it, depending on if I like it or not. It's the authenticity. Just keep rolling. That's right. All right. Amelia, do you have any plugs that maybe, or shout outs that you like to? I know you play at a couple bars and gigs and pubs.
Yeah, sure. So my friends own a craft beer tap house in Brownwood, Texas. It's called Pioneer Tap House. They're awesome. They're really good people. And they've been really good to me. So yeah, if anybody's in the Brownwood, Abilene, Cross Plains, any area around here, please go check them out. And then I do want to plug Whittle Woodworking. They're out of Abilene, Texas. And
oh, cool. Earrings.
Yeah, they've actually they've done this whole line that's the Amelia Presley collection, and this is one of the pieces, and then this necklace as well. I like to mix and match my earrings in my words because I can't talk today. So I've only got one of the earrings on,
That's awesome. I love it. That's great. Yeah, no, we'll plug that. That's the Amelia Presley line?
The Amelia Presley collection at Whittle Woodworking.
Look at you. You're a famous star over there. The benefits of being a country star.
Oh, did you notice my Go postcard?
No, we didn't. There it is.
Well, I dug this out of the recesses of underneath my bed just for this.
Wow.
I actually got this from the recruiter in 2010.
Oh my God. Look at that. So you still kept it?
Yeah, I did. I have worn it maybe one time.
And our episode. That's how special our episode is.
That's right. You're also seeing this for the first time.
Well, we are truly honored, Amelia. I mean, it's been so much fun catching up with you. And obviously, you're a hero to our country for your service. But we have to kick you out. But before we kick you out, and we love Crossplane so much, all we ask is for a song. Do you mind?
I guess I could come up with something.
Okay, I hope so. What song could you play for us before we leave here?
I'll do Harm Nobody Else, since it is releasing for pre-save and pre-order this Friday.
Oh, well, Amelia, thank you so much. We'll let you play it. Go ahead whenever you're ready.
But I'm healing every day. Oh, I still feel the word. said, though I'm not the same. No, I'm done. I'm laying down the gun. Take your depression. Don't harm nobody else. Now I'm a liar, 'cause I was taught to hide the truth. Oh, you burned down my youth, 'cause you couldn't love yourself. Said I'm done. Oh, I'm laying down the gun. Take your depression. Don't harm nobody else. Said I'm a liar, 'cause I was taught to hide the truth. Oh, you burned down my youth, 'cause you couldn't love yourself. Now it's hard to love myself, but I don't harm nobody else.
I thank you so much for your time. We really appreciate it. Again, thank you for your service, and thanks for showing us around Cross Plains, Texas.
Thank you so much for coming and raising the population to 901.
Anytime. Well, stay healthy and safe, and we hope to run into you again soon.
All right.
And good luck with the new single.
Thank you.
All right, thank you.